If the term company secretary makes you imagine a secretary, then think again, because they have nothing to do with regular secretarial work. In fact, a company secretary or a CS is a professional whose role in a corporate setup is that of an advisor for legal matters. A CS is a very important member of the company's management.
You know, company secretary is a very important link between the board of directors of a company and its various stakeholders. Stakeholders include the employees, the shareholders, the stock exchanges, the regulators like regional director, the registrar of companies, banks, financial institutions, and the society at large. So one of the major role of a company secretary is to implement the policies of the board of directors. In addition, the company secretary advises the boards and companies on very sensitive and complicated issues like corporate governance, corporate social responsibility, mergers, amalgamations, takeovers, intellectual property rights, how to raise funds from the capital markets, and so on and so forth.
The course of company secretary is a prestigious one and at the same time financially rewarding too. What's more, once you become a company secretary, you get to hobnob with top bosses of the corporate world. Therefore, it isn't surprising that a lot of young people are pursuing this course.
Once I did my 12th, I didn't really know what to do. So I followed the advice of a lot of people who suggested that I should preferably do a professional course, which would basically give me a direct access or an entry into the corporate world. So they suggested that I should do CS, which is the only course which actually gives you a direct entry into the boardroom of a company, even as a fresher. So paying heed to good advice, I decided to join CS.
There are basically three stages that a youngster has to go through and clear in order to become a CS. If one has done graduation, then they have to undergo only two stages, while those who wish to pursue this field right after plus two have to complete all the three stages.
There are two ways to join this course. One is for 10 plus 2 students. They can directly join the foundation course, which is the first level of the course. So when they appear for the examination, they could register themselves provisionally for the foundation course. And after they pass the 12th examination, their registration becomes regular. So that is one route. For those students who have done their graduation, they can directly join the second level of the course, which is called executive program. So they don't have to go through the foundation program. They can join the second level. All the graduates except who have done graduation in fine arts. So it could be from any stream, you know, a science graduate or an arts graduate or a commerce graduate, from any of the discipline could join the second level of the course. A student from 10 plus 2 with any percentage, if he has passed it, he can register himself for the foundation. And similarly, any graduate, with whatever percentage he has scored, if he has passed the graduation, he can join this course. There is no entrance exam, there is no entry barrier.
The best part of choosing this career is students from any stream can opt for it. Though a popular misconception is that commerce stream students opt more for this field and also do well as company secretary.
The course is open for everybody. There are a number of students from the science stream who join the course or from the arts stream. I am myself a science graduate and I have done this course. There are also examples where students have done their IIT, their engineering, their medical, their management courses, and they have also joined this course. So it's only a perception. But this is also a fact that a large number of students who have done their commerce, they do join this course because there are some subjects which are common, like company law, accounts, commercial laws. These are the subjects which are taught in the commerce course also, and which are also a part of this course. So in terms of, comfortability, commerce graduates feel that they are more comfortable to do this course. But otherwise, any student from any stream is most welcome to join this course.
A company secretary is recognized as one of the principal officers of the company, and they are required to carry out functions in various areas, such as finance, accounts, legal administration, and personnel division. Hence, the training as a company secretary equips a person to provide these services and transform the students into modern corporate professionals.
The course has two components. One is the academic inputs. We have got total 18 papers that students have to pass. At the foundation stage, we have got 4 papers where we test their knowledge on elementary subjects like English, etc. And that's very elementary. That's the level is that of 12th standard. But once he joins the executive program, and then finally the third stage and the final stage is the professional program. There, you know, they are imparted knowledge on subjects like company law, commercial laws, drafting skills, how to pass resolutions, how to conduct board meetings, how to conduct annual general meetings. Then there are very important issues which are taught to them, dealing with corporate governance, ethics, sustainability. So these are subjects which are taught to them on capital markets, on securities management, stock exchanges. So, I mean, these are some very complicated issues on which corporates have to deal on day-to-day basis. So these 18 papers they have to pass, that is one part of the course. In addition to that, students have to go through 16 months training. There is a 15 months management training. After they do that, then there is a 15 days training with the registrar of companies or stock exchanges. And then there is a 15 months training, which is called MSOP. It's Management Orientation Program, where we invite best of the faculties from industry, from regulatory bodies, and we open them to the live problems, you know. I mean, for instance, how to conduct a board meeting. So we will conduct a mock board meeting. The students will sit, somebody will act as a chairman, somebody will act as a director, somebody will act as a secretary, and live problems are given to them and they are asked to deal with those problems. So once this both the components are over, that is, he passes all the three streams, that is foundation, executive program and professional program, and also completes the training components, then we admit him as a associate member of the institute. He can write ACS, Associate Company Secretary, and he becomes a member, and then he can start his career.
Basically, company secretaries focus on laws, predominantly company laws, but it's not confined to that. We do a lot of other laws like labor laws, FEMA, that's foreign exchange management. We do a lot of industrial laws, we do patents, we do IPR laws, all that we do. Apart from that, we also are provided with a basic level knowledge of economics, accountancy, finance, stock exchanges, all of that. So you need to be completely aware of your surroundings. It's not only law, but you need to concentrate on a lot of law. Different laws, but predominantly company law, SEBI regulations, stock exchanges, all of that.
The Institute of Company Secretary of India, or the ICSI, imparts training in company secretaryship by distance learning, enabling students to qualify as company secretaries. The company secretary course conducted by the institute is a mixture of postal tuition and optional coaching classes.
Our institute has a lot of periodical programs that we need to do. So we have ADPs, we have SMTPs, we have TOP programs. So all of that actually gives you access to the best of the faculty. They come, they share their experiences, they kind of polish us. And also the curriculum, like I said, it gives us knowledge. It prepares us for the practical world. We can come here, attend seminars, attend sessions, know what to do, know what not to do. So in all, once you complete the course, you come out as a complete polished package.
Companies need advice from a person with a thorough knowledge of all relevant laws. This service is provided for by a company secretary. So the employment potential in corporate sector is very high.
After a student is admitted as a member of the institute, he has got two options available. One is that he can go for a job. And another is that he can start his independent practice. And we call it as a practicing company secretary. That means he is not attached to any company. He is not employed, but he starts his own practice. Now, as far as job is concerned, which is the first stream, you know, he can start job with any of the corporates as a company secretary. And if the corporate